audience please stand?
This weekend is a significant one. It is 25 years since the weekend they went on their first date. We appreciate the generous way they have shared with us how they met, came together, sought to become the ideal person to each other, how they dealt with hardship and shared joy, mourned the death of loved ones, and rejoiced in the birth of their children. We appreciate the thoughtful way they acknowledge their shared path and individual paths as they sought new perspective.
We sought their desire to learn a deeper love for themselves, for their children, and for each other. In Corinthians we read, "Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself, is not puffed up, does not behave rudely, does not seek its own, is not provoked, thinks no evil, does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth, bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. In all of your experiences, what comes through is the way that you both have chosen to learn to be kind to each other. Marriage is an opportunity to learn a deeper kind of love without conditions and always, not just when it's easy and convenient, but when it is hard and when we don't feel like it. When problems and difficulties arise, something inherent in all marriages, we encourage you to continue to work things out between the two of you through love, compassion, and compromise."
One movie that we enjoy is Shall We Dance? And in it, the character played by Susan Sarandon offers one of our favorite quotes regarding why we have marriage. She says, "We need a witness to our lives. There's a billion people on the planet. I mean, what does any one life really mean? But in a marriage, you're promising to care about everything. The good things, the bad things, the terrible things, the mundane things, all of it, all of the time, every day. You're saying, your life will not go unnoticed because I will notice it. Your life will not go unwitnessed because I will be your witness. I love the idea that being aware of each other, noticing, seeing each other is a wonderful part of a marriage. All of you who are here today play an important part as well. You are a witness of the vows and promises that Brian and Shan will make to and with each other. You can be a strength and a support to them in the years to come."
Mike was not on, was it? Great. Marriage is a wonderful union. One of the greatest joys in life is the magic of being needed, loved, loved by your spouse. Happiness in marriage is not just something that happens. Marriages are formed every day, but great and lasting marriages must be created and nourished tenderly, courageously, and constantly every moment. The little things become the big things: caring, courting, giving, and forgiving. Marriage has a way of confronting all of us. As Shakespeare says, it is a school of love. Shan and Brian were at the same school together for 20 years, and then they saw they needed to go separate schools for a while. They continued to learn love. Choosing to do so led them back together. Sometimes one of the hardest things to give up is our own idea of what life is supposed to look like. Yet in giving up what they thought should happen and embracing new possibility for what can happen, something so much greater, so much greater than what we can imagine, can now show up.
Thank you both for being people who learn to love in new ways and to create space for greater things than what you could have imagined when you first met 25 years ago. In Isaiah we read, "For the past troubles will be forgotten and hidden from our eyes. See, I will create new heavens and a new earth. The former things will not be remembered, nor will they come to mind. But be glad and rejoice forever in what I will create." Shan and Brian, we are all grateful to be with you on this day as you begin a new chapter in your lives. We look forward to seeing this new life that you create together.
We invite their children, Max, Grace, and Lily, to share a few comments and thoughts.
My best friend Alicia is taking pictures back there. Made me read a really sad book one time, Little Women's, and you may have heard of it. But I really liked a quote from that, and I thought I would introduce my words with. So the little prince lived on a small planet, and on it he had a rose that he loved. And someone talking to him about. Or him talking to his rose, he said, "Of course I'll hurt you. Of course you'll hurt me. Of course we will hurt each other. But this is the very condition of existence. To become spring means accepting the risk of winter. To become presence means accepting the risk of absence." So, our lives as a family have been full of a lot of different presences and absences and so on. A lot of combination of all of those. And all the presences don't always negate the sadness of the absences. Likewise, the absences don't ruin our presences. And now we're, a new emerging.
So close.
I'm trying.
It's nice to have such an inspiring example from them for all the presences and absences and how those can, make life meaningful, both the absences and the presences. And, my dad texted me a quote from Doctor Who to share. What a nerd. But I won't share that one. I'll share a different one, though. There's a different episode of Doctor Who than the one that he sent me that I enjoyed a lot better, where he talks about the life of the artist, Vincent Van Gogh, and he says about him, after contemplating his suicide, that every life is a combination of good things and bad things. And while the good things don't always soften the bad things never ruin the good things. And so it's all about how it all adds up. And I feel our lives as a family have added up and amounted to a lot of good things. And now we're starting a new chapter of even more good things. So I think that'll be good. One of my favorite philosophers, I'll end with this, Friedrich Nietzsche, said something that I really enjoy as well. He said, I overcame myself, the sufferer. I carried my own ashes to the mountains, and I invented a brighter flame for myself. Because how can we not first become new if we are not at one point ash? So I feel like we're going to be a really great new family. So congratulations, guys.
Thank you, sir. So I'm just pointing at both of you because we have lots of paper and pens at the house. We've written these down rather than
So I'm a poetry person. And so I have a poem from our friend. And it's love comes quietly, find drops about me on me in the old ways. What did I am, thinking myself able to go? So my parents' relationship is rooted in a promise to be each other's family, and they've been there for each other just to be there for a very long time. And this promise has been replanted and grown into true unconditional love and gratitude for each other and for my siblings and I. And this appreciation and respect I have for both of them is too big to articulate. And the best and only lesson I'll ever need from them is to show gratitude.
I love you because of how fiercely you love our children. I love you because how passionate you are about the world and things that you care about. And I love you because I enjoy being around you wherever we are, whether that's someplace new or just sitting on the couch. From this day forward, I vow to love you unconditionally, to listen to you and all of your problems and try not to face them unless you ask me. I vow to share everything I have with you, and I vow to continually work on my sense of humor and my joke telling, because while it is impressive now, it can only improve with time.
That's true.
I vow to park closer to the store if possible. I vow to take care of you through the good and bad, and you'll always be your friend. I love you.
So, I wrote a thing.
Okay.
On paper, so I'm not in trouble.
Yes.
So, 25 years ago this month, I sat in a bagel shop and I listened to you talk about the woman that you wanted to marry someday. And I think that in that moment, I sort of fell a little bit in love with you, like right from the start. I also so bad wanted to be that woman because she was fierce and independent and ambitious and brave, and I wanted to be that at that time in my life, and I didn't realize that by spending my life with you and being around your kindness and tact and courage and thoughtfulness and kindness that you would make me be that person. So my life, I'm this person, this super chill all the time person, because I am loved by you, and I am so grateful for that. I have to embarrass you for one quick second. You are the most thoughtful person in the world, and I don't think anybody knows that, so I'm making this known now. Yeah. So this morning, like, here's the example of thoughtfulness. I wake up and I say, oh man, I didn't have any coffee or caffeine yesterday. I'm gonna have the worst headache today. And before I even like had my makeup on, you brought me a cup of coffee. And then the best part was that I mentioned to you how I feel like when we talk to Alexa that we're not very nice to her, because we say stop without saying please, and it always feels weird to me. And so when you told her to shut the timer off this morning, you said, Alexa, please shut the timer off. And it was just an example of how sweet you are. Okay, anyway, so from this day on, I promise that I will leave my shoes in the middle of the living room every single day, that I will eventually pick them up. And I promise that I will live and look for adventure in every single day of our life together, even the hard ones. And I promise to walk with you all the way through the rest of our life, no matter what that brings, and I will always reach out for your arm. And I have to remember, I promise that I will forgive you when you steal the blankets every night before I'm able to do it first. And that I will show you gratitude for the thousand things that you do for me every single day of my life, little and big. And that I will love you beyond space and time with my whole heart, always and always. Sorry, we're kissing each other. No one else needs to.
Complex journey for 25 years. That is no understatement.
You have rejoiced in sorrow, you have joined together, and also journeyed apart. Now you are drawn back together, stronger than ever.
It is wonderful the way you have found that the person you each hoped to become for each other, for yourselves, that person is here. You are perfect for yourselves, for each other, because you are here together. Because you exist right here. Because you choose to love when it is easy, when it is hard, when it is exciting, when it is boring, and all the times in between. Brian Vincent Sullivan and Shan Reese Sullivan, do you promise to be partners in all ways, legally, emotionally, physically, spiritually, intimately, as parents, friends, and lovers? Do you promise to create your journeys as individuals who are learning to intertwine paths? Whatever this life brings, honoring the wonder, the joy, the challenge, and beauty of sharing your incredible lives.
The ring is an ancient symbol. It's so perfect and yet so simple as well. It has no beginning and no end because it is a circle. For love is given and comes back again. The hole in the center of the ring also has significance. It isn't just considered a space, but rather a gateway or a door leading to things and events, both known and unknown. Your rings are precious because you wear them with love. They symbolize your commitment in marriage. They remind you of who you are, who you've been, and where you're going. As you wear them, they will reflect not only who you are as individuals, but who you are as a couple. The wedding ring is an outward sign of an inward and spiritual commitment and bond which unites you together.
And now, as a token of your love for each other and your desire to be forever united, please exchange rings.
Mingle and have lunch. We are grateful that you're here, and please enjoy one another's company.